Hi, it's Cheryl here today, and I am here today to show you how to make this cute little Barbie purse. And you can all do this with a long strap or a short strap and just make it into a purse charm for yourself. As you can see, it is fillable and it holds plenty of things because Barbie's got all her little things in it. So it holds quite a bit. And I'm going to show you how to put a button on it. And like I said, you can make it with just like a little short strap if you want. So you can use it like a charm, or you can make it with a long strap so it'll fit up over Barbie's shoulder if you want to use it with your doll. I'm going to show you how to make this on the loom today. So let's get started. Okay, to get started on the Barbie purse, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to start it out just like you would do a double cap dragon scale. You're going to take your two bands and twist them into an 8. And then two more bands and twist them into an 8. You need this on 6 pegs, so we're going to move up this way and put them on here, 2 more. So we've got it on 6 different pegs. I'm going to take an alternating color. You can use the same color if you want to. I just prefer to use a different color. And put it 2 bands at a time on the alternating pegs. So the setup is the same as a double cap dragon scale. Then I'm going to take my hook and I'm going to pull the bottom 2 up, over, and behind. And you see that it untwists this last one. So I'm going to take this last one, lift it off, and I'm actually twisting it again and putting it back on. And I'm pushing everything down. And I'm going to take and put another row on, 2 at a time, just like the first 2 rows. Then I'm lifting the bottom over the top, 2 over 2, up and over into the back. Making sure every time I'm lifting 2 bands over 2 bands, push everything down. At this point, I'm done the base of the purse, and I'm going to turn it around and I'm going to take these 8s that I've made and I'm going to stretch these across. So I'm going to take my hook and put it in the first piece of this 8 and pull it to here, and then I'm going to put it in the second part of the 8. They're a little tight, so it's a matter of getting it into them. And I'm going to put it on this hook. I'm going to do the same thing for here and here. So this one's going to here. And that one to there. This one. Here, and this one to here, and that is for the bottom of our purse, our bag. Okay, now we're ready to start the top, which I think I'm going to make green. So I'm going to start that, and all you're going to do for that is you're going to start putting your bands on from here. Make sure everything's pushed down, and you're just going to put them on like so, around in a chain. Doesn't matter where you start these. I'll just stay in order after you started them. So you start where you want and just go around in a circle. So you completed your circle. And you're going to go all the way around and pull the bottom two over the top two, up and around and into the center. Making sure that you get two at a time every time. You don't have to do it from the office side like I am. I'm just doing this so you get a good view of it from both sides. You pull one off, just hook it back on. Everything down, and you're just going to keep doing the exact same thing. Doesn't matter where you start, just go around in a circle. Make the bag as deep as you want. I don't know whether you hear that funny little sniffing sound. My doggy is at my door sniffing away, making puffy noises because he wants to come in. So if you're having a hard time pulling them over two at once, pull them over one at a time. So I have the Rainbow Loom new hook on order. I'm looking forward to getting that. I know a lot of you have told me it's a great hook, so I'm really looking forward to that coming. And I was on the Rainbow Loom member site today, and I saw that my boa constrictor bracelet on the monster tail loom is on there. That was very exciting to see. And so we've got two rows now. We'll do a couple more with you. The bands I'm using, if you're newer to my videos, are from LuckyLoom.com. I'm sorry, the Lucky Loom Band Company, and you can find them on Amazon.com. And if you go look at my website, WillowCreek.com, you can find their coupon code there. And you can get them for about 30% off, which is a really good discount on them. I use these bands and I use Rainbow Loom bands. They're the only two bands that I, two companies that I get bands from, Rainbow Loom and Lucky Loom Company. I only use silicone bands. All right, I'm going to pause and do a few more rows, and then I'll come back and show you how to take this off the loom. Okay, I'm ready to take this off now, off the loom, and I'm going to show you how I did that, how I do that. We're starting at the end, and I'm going to take these two off first, and you can do this one of two ways. You can either lift up this piece and lift it over the end, or you can pick it up and pull it through. I'll show you the other way. You can lift it up that way. You're going to take each of these and pull them through separately, or you can take it off, twist your hook, and slide it through. That's the way I usually do it, but you can do it either way. But you're going to go around here, and every one of these is going to go through separately. So like I said, you can lift it over or you can slide it through. So you're not doing two at a time, you're doing one at a time. Even though each peg has two, you're going to do each one separately. And do it whatever ways you are more comfortable with, lifting it over or sliding it through. Doesn't matter which one you could do first, if they end up with one in backwards order, whether it's this side first or that side first, that doesn't matter. As long as you're just doing one before the other. So you can see what it's doing as we go along. See, I'm holding on to it. It also helps. I'm holding this band. Or, like I said, you can lift them over. And do that with each one, too. One. Oh no, I didn't. That's just looser. Okay. We only got two left. This is our last one, so it'll come through, and this is where you're going to start your chain for your handle. I'm trying to think my word there, your handle. Okay, so that took me all the way around to there. And I ended up with three here because, as you saw, what I did was I took an extra band pushed through here, pulled it through, put it on the hook, and then when I chain here, I'm going to pull it through all three of these and put it on the hook. Now I can chain. I'm just going to do enough to do a short handle because, you know, all you have to do is add a little bit more for a longer one. So that's easy enough to do. So let me get a few more bands out here and I'll show you how to do a little handle and attach it. My pink and green almost looks like red and green. It looks Christmassy. maybe a few more. But it gives you a nice opening. You get plenty of space out of this bag, as you can see. You can put lots of stuff in it. That's enough of a handle. All I did with to attach it was use a clip, but you can also make sure I get it even enough. You can also tie it off if you don't want to just use a clip. So I'm going to show you how to tie it off. If you're going to tie it, actually I'm going to tie it on the inside. So I'm going to pull everything to the inside. I'm going to take that off the hook. I'm going to put the hook through here and through here. So I'm going to pull everything into the inside. So I'm pulling the band through those two. Putting it back on. And then I'm going to pull it through itself. But I want it to be on the inside where I'm tying it, not on the outside where it's going to show. And then I'm going to put my scissors up here. Maybe not. Guess I'm just going to break it. Okay. Then I'll pull this extra piece through a little spot somewhere so I can tie it. There we have it. Alright, now I want to show you how to put the button on the front too. Because I think that the button gives it a lot of style too. Alright, so for the button, you can thread this by hand, which is always fun getting the band through there. I have a hard time doing it, so I cheat and use my hook. It is possible to get the band through the button. It just takes a little more time. So like I said, I use my hook and I pull it through. You pull it through the button. You wrap the band around the button once it's through and lock it in place. Then you put your hook through your bag. Grab your band, pull it through, and then I'm going to pull it through the button again on the other side. Or I can just pull it around my button again, like I'm buttoning it in place. Just going to wrap it right around my button again. There you go, and my button is buttoned on. So there you have it, the Barbie purse, Barbie bag. So I hope you like it. And thank you for watching. And if you have any questions, please let me know. And please check out my other videos. Also, I have a website that I've started. You can find it at CherylMayberry.com or WillowCrete.com. Please check it out. I have my videos organized by how they're made, like if they're made on the rainbow loom or if they're made on the monster tail loom or by fork. Please check it out. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching.